After the end of World War II, the world was split into two, East and West. This marked the beginning of the era called the Cold War.
Approaching Soviet airspace.
20 minutes to drop off.
Commencing internal depressurization. Equipment check. Arm main parachute.
All right. You ready to go?
Drop zone still showing a high pressure mass. Cav okay.
Good. We've got high visibility.
Cigar. Connecting oxygen hose to interior connector. Put on your mask. Does this panty waist know what he's doing?
Approaching release point.
10 minutes to drop off.
Hey, are you deaf?
He said put out the cigar and put on your mask.
Depressurization complete.
Checking oxygen supply.
6 minutes to drop off. Opening rear hatch.
Sunrise.
External temperature minus 46 degrees Celsius. 2 minutes to drop off. Stand up.
You'll be falling at 130 miles per hour. Try not to get frostbite from the wind chill.
1 minute to drop off. Move to the rear.
This is one for the history books. The world's first halo jump.
10 seconds to drop off. Stand by. Status okay. All green.
Prepare for drop off. Countdown. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Spread your wings
and fly. God be with you.
Jack, I've got some important news. The head of the CIA has finally given us the green light for the virtuous mission.
Virtual mission?
No, the virtuous mission. The future of our Fox unit depends on it. If it succeeds, we'll be officially organized into a unit.
Virtuous mission? Sounds like some kind of initiation ritual.
You know, don't get cocky. This isn't a training op.
Right. So what exactly is this wonderful mission?
Well, about 2 years ago, a certain Soviet scientist requested asylum in the West through one of our moles. His name is Nikolai Stepanovich Sokolov. He's head of the OKB-754 Design Bureau, one of the Soviet's top-secret weapon research facilities, and the East's foremost expert on weapons development.
Sokolov? Isn't he that famous rocket scientist?
The very same. On April the 12th, 1961, the Soviets achieved the first manned spaceflight in history.
The Earth was blue, but there was no God.
Well spoken. The rocket that carried Yuri Gagarin to orbit was the A-1, known as the Vostok rocket. Sokolov is said to be the man most responsible for the multi-engine cluster used in that rocket. After Gagarin's flight, Sokolov left rocket development to become the head of the newly established design bureau.
From a lowly technician to head of a design bureau, that's quite a success story. So why'd he want to defect?
It seems he'd become afraid of his own creations.
Afraid?
Call it a crisis of conscience.
And for that, he left his country and his family behind and went over the fence?
Not exactly. One of his conditions was that his family was also to be taken safely to the West. We used a mole to get the family out first and succeeded in sneaking Sokolov over the Berlin Wall shortly afterwards. I was the one who conducted the operation.
The security on the eastern side was still full of holes back then. Then what?
We got Sokolov over in one piece, but the whole ordeal had left him exhausted, and we checked him into a hospital in West Berlin. It took him 2 weeks and more than 600 miles to get from the research facility in the Soviet Union to Berlin. He was in no condition to say anything coherent. And it was only a week later that we had something much bigger on our hands.
The Cuban Missile Crisis.
October the 16th, 1962, President Kennedy received word that the Soviets were in the process of deploying intermediate-range ballistic missiles in Cuba. The president demanded that the Soviets dismantle and remove the missiles. At the same time, he announced a naval blockade to prevent further missile shipments from reaching Cuba. But the Soviets didn't back down, instead placing their armed forces on secondary alert. Soviet transport ships carrying missiles continued on course towards Cuba. US and Soviet forces went on alert for an all-out nuclear war. Frantic negotiations were conducted through the UN's Emergency Security Council and unofficial channels to end the hair-trigger standoff. Finally, on October the 28th, the Soviet Union agreed to remove its missiles from Cuba. And so the world avoided a nuclear holocaust. But in order to get the Soviets to pull their missiles out, we had to make a deal.
You mean the one where the U.S. agreed to remove its IRBMs from Turkey?
No. The Jupiter IRBMs deployed in Turkey were obsolete, and we were going to get rid of them anyway. They had no strategic value whatsoever to either the U.S. or the Russians. The Turkey deal was a ruse, a cover story that was fed to the other intelligence agencies around the world.
So what did the Russians really want?
Sokolov. They wanted us to return Sokolov.
You mean the Soviets pulled out of Cuba just to get their hands on Sokolov?
That's right.
What the hell was he working on?
At the time, we had no idea. We were running out of time. It was either give up Sokolov or risk full-scale nuclear war. In the end, we had no choice. President Kennedy gave in to Khrushchev's demand. The next day, I got Sokolov out of the hospital, handing him over to agents on the eastern side. Sokolov kept on screaming, "Save me," until he disappeared from my sight. Then a month ago, we received some new information from one of our moles.
About Sokolov?
Yes. He was taken back to the research facility and forced to continue working on the weapon in question under KGB supervision. What's more, it's on the verge of completion.
So what kind of weapon is it? Something to do with space rockets?
No. Missiles.
Same technology.
I guess you're right. We don't know the details, but it appears to be a new kind of nuclear device. For half a year now, the Soviets have been conducting frequent nuclear tests at Semipalatinsk.
Something to do with the weapon, I assume.
We're talking about a secret weapon so big that Khrushchev was ready to pull out of Cuba to get it back.
Is Sokolov still in the facility?
No. According to our intelligence, he's in Selenoyarsk, a place in the mountains about 3 miles to the west that's known as the Virgin Cliffs.
The Virgin Cliffs. Nice name for a virtuous mission.
They moved him there just recently.
Why?
Apparently, they're conducting a field test of the weapon, but it's our best chance to get him back. This mission would never have been possible if he was still in the research facility. This is our last chance. Sokolov must have known that, too, when he contacted us.
Jack.
Your mission is to infiltrate Selino Yask in the Soviet mountains, ensure the safety of Sokolov, and bring him back to the West. If we don't get Sokolov back before that weapon is complete, we'll be facing a major crisis. The clock is ticking. Once we've confirmed the rescue of Sokolov, stand by at the recovery point. A recovery balloon will be dropped at that point. Helium will be pumped into the balloon to inflate it. The process takes about 20 minutes. Once it's complete, the gunship's arm will latch onto the balloon and pull it up.
The Fulton surface-to-air recovery system. I'm familiar with the theory.
Take it easy. It's been combat-proven.
Do you think Sokolov is up to it?
The shock will be less than during a parachute jump, and the arm can handle up to 500 pounds.
So you're planning on going over the border in a single combat talent?
She's equipped with 2 6-barrel 20mm Vulcan cannons, as well as 2 40mm machine guns.
Sounds like she could hold her own against a battalion of tanks.
Even with the fuel in the reserve tank, we're facing a 4-hour time limit. If all goes well, it shouldn't take more than a few hours.
Home in time for dinner.
But if anything goes wrong,
you'll be eating dinner, breakfast,
and all the rest of your meals in the jungle. Do you copy? You're already in enemy territory, and somebody might be listening in. From here on out, we'll be using code names to refer to each other. Your code name for this mission will be Naked Snake. I'll be referring to you as Snake from now on. You're not to mention your real name.
Snake?
What, you don't like snakes?
What do you mean?
You've eaten one before, haven't you?
In survival training.
I'm glad to hear that.
I don't know if I'd ever order one in a restaurant, but...
Be careful. You might not have a choice.
What about you, Major? What should I call you?
Let's see. I'll be Tom. Call me Major Tom. This will be a sneaking mission. You must not be seen by the enemy. You must leave no trace of your presence. Is that clear? This kind of infiltration is the Fox unit's speciality. In other words, weapons and equipment are procured on site. That goes for food as well. You're completely naked, just as your name implies.
Great. Now I see why you asked me if I like snakes. I suppose calling me Snake was your idea of a joke, too.
No. There's a good reason for that. I'll tell you later when the time is right.
Gotcha. Getting back to the subject, how exactly am I supposed to feed myself?
You've been issued a knife and a tranquilizer gun. Use them to hunt for food. You'll also find some medical supplies in your backpack.
Yeah, about the backpack. I lost it in a tree on the way down.
I see. Well, you'd better go back and get it then. You know where it is?
No problem. I can see it from here. It's stuck on a branch.
To climb a tree, stand in front of a tree that's covered in ivy and press the action button. I'll be monitoring your progress over the radio. We can't risk violating Soviet airspace, but I'll be in the gunship. My frequency is 140.85. I'll give you a call if I need to talk to you. If you need to talk to me, use the send function. Okay, Snake, go get your backpack. I see you've retrieved your backpack, Snake. To equip a weapon, it's necessary to take it out of your backpack. In the Survival Viewer, choose Weapon from the backpack. Your available weapons will be displayed in a window in the upper left. From that list, choose the weapon you want to equip and press the Enter button. For other equipped items, just do the same thing from Item.
Got it. Use the Survival Viewer backpack.
Yep, that's right. Survival is fundamental to this mission. After you've been out in the field for a while, your stamina will start to drop. If your stamina gets too low, it'll affect your performance. You won't be able to shoot accurately, for example, and your wounds won't heal as smoothly. Keep an eye on your stamina so you don't run out. To recover lost stamina, you can hunt for local flora and fauna. You can use either your tranquilizer gun or your knife to hunt.
My only weapon is a Mark 22 Hush Puppy tranquilizer gun?
That's right. It's been fitted with its own suppressor. However, the suppressor will deteriorate every time you fire. Once its durability reaches zero, the noise suppression effect will be gone. So don't get too trigger happy with it. The suppressor's durability is shown in the icon. Any weapons and equipment beyond what you're carrying now, you'll have to find as you go.
I have to find my own weapons and equipment? Whose crazy idea was this anyway?
Solo covert actions are standard Fox operating procedure. You can't leave any traces of your presence. No weapons, equipment, footprints, sweat, or bodily waste. The same goes for bullets and cartridges, too. Your presence in enemy territory is already a violation of international conventions of warfare. There aren't supposed to be any American soldiers in Russia. It could spark an international incident. You can't let anyone see you. You can't let the enemy know you're there. This is a stealth mission. You're a ghost, Snake, in every sense of the word. And there'll be no rescue if you're captured. The military and U.S. government will deny any involvement in the affair.
Then I'll just have to take care of myself, huh?
I'm afraid so. You've been given a fake death pill for that purpose. SIS guidelines stipulate that soldiers on covert ops like this one be issued a potassium cyanide capsule. Tape it to your body so you can take it when you need to.
How generous of you.
Use it if you're taken prisoner by the enemy. It'll send you into a state of false death for a short time.
Fooling them into thinking that I'm really dead. So how do I come back to life?
Just take the revival pill.
You mean that thing they put in my tooth before the mission?
That's the one. But be careful. If you remain in a state of false death for too long, nothing will be able to bring you back. Remember that.
I'll keep it in mind. You said this was a solo mission, right?
Right.
I guess that means I can't count on any reinforcements.
Correct. The mission rests entirely in your hands.
A real one-man army.
Relax. There's a support team ready to back you up over the radio.
Who?
I'll introduce them to you. This time, survival is of utmost importance. The first member of the support team will be in charge of monitoring your physical condition, acting as a medic, so to speak, as well as recording your mission data. She's a member of FOX as well, and she's here on the gunship with me.
She?
Hello, Snake. I'm paramedic. Nice to meet you.
Paramedic?
As in a medic who comes in by parachute.
Aren't you going to tell me your real name?
Are you going to tell me yours, Mr. Snake?
My name, huh? It's John Doe.
And they call you Jack for short. You're a regular Captain Nemo.
A name means nothing on the battlefield. After a week, no one has a name. What's your name?
Jane Doe.
Very funny.
I wasn't joking, but I'll tell you my name only if you manage to make it back alive. My frequency is 145.73.
She's also in charge of recording your mission data. Whenever you want to save, send a message over the reserved save frequency, 140.96.
So saving lets me record my mission data.
That's right. It also records the state of your health.
Good to know.
There's one more person I want to introduce you to, Snake.
Huh?
Speaking of snakes, you remember the boss, don't you? A legendary soldier and your mentor. Actually, it was the boss that got the DCI's authorization in the first place. She's going to be serving as Fox's mission advisor.
The boss is?
She also helped me plan this mission. She and I were at SAS together.
Jack, is that you? How many years has it been?
Boss?
That's right. It's me.
Oh.
Talk to me. Let me hear your voice.
It's been 5 years, 72 days, and 18 hours.
You've lost weight.
You can tell just by the sound of my voice.
Of course I can. I know all about you.
Really? Well, I don't know anything about you.
What's that supposed to mean?
Why'd you disappear on me all of a sudden?
I was on a top secret mission. You didn't need me anymore.
But there were still so many things I wanted you to teach me.
No, I taught you everything you needed to know about fighting techniques. I taught you all I could. The rest you needed to learn on your own.
Techniques, sure. But what about how to think like a soldier?
How to think like a soldier? I can't teach you that. A soldier needs to be strong in spirit, body, and technique. And the only thing you can learn from someone else is technique. In fact, technique doesn't even matter. What's most important is spirit. Spirit and body are like two sides of a single coin. They're the same thing. I can't teach you how to think. You'll just have to figure it out for yourself. Listen to me, Jack. Just because soldiers are on the same side right now doesn't mean they always will be. Having personal feelings about your comrades is one of the worst sins you can commit. Politics determine who you face on the battlefield. And politics are a living thing. They change along with the times. Yesterday's good might be tomorrow's evil.
Is that why you abandoned me?
No, it had nothing to do with you. I already told you, Jack, I was on a top secret mission. A soldier has to follow whatever orders he's given. It's not his place to question why. But you're looking for a reason to fight. You're a natural born fighter, but you're not quite a soldier. A soldier is a political tool, nothing more. That's doubly true if he's a career soldier. Right and wrong have no place in his mission. He has no enemies and no friends. Only the mission. You follow the orders you're given. That's what being a soldier is.
I do whatever I have to get the job done. I don't think about politics.
That's not the same thing. Sooner or later, your conscience is going to bother you. In the end, you have to choose whether you're going to live as a soldier or just another man with a gun. There's a saying, loyalty to the end. Do you know what it means?
Being patriotic.
It means devoting yourself to your country.
I follow the president and the top brass. I'm ready to die for them if necessary.
The president and the top brass won't be there forever. Once their terms are up, others will take their place.
I follow the will of the leader, no matter who's in charge.
People aren't the ones who dictate the missions.
Then who does?
The times. People's values change over time, and so do the leaders of a country. So there's no such thing as an enemy in absolute terms. The enemies we fight are only enemies in relative terms, constantly changing with the times. As long as we have loyalty to the end, there's no point in believing in anything, even in those we love.
And that's the way a soldier's supposed to think.
The only thing we can believe in with absolute certainty is the mission, Jack.
All right, but do me a favor.
What is it?
Call me Snake.
Snake? Oh, right. Your code name is Snake. It suits you well.
That's right. The legendary unit that the boss put together during World War II was a snake. The Cobra unit. A group of heroes that brought the war to an end and saved the world. As long as you've got a legendary hero backing you up, you'll be fine. Isn't that right, Snake?
Yeah. I can't think of anyone else I'd rather have with me. Oh, and one more thing, boss.
Yes?
It's good to hear your voice again.
Same here. After all, who knows if either of us will make it out alive? Snake, you are always best at urban warfare and infiltrating buildings. But this is the jungle. Survival is going to be key. Those CQC techniques I taught you are sure to come in handy.
CQC? Close quarters combat, huh? I've been in the Green Berets for the past few years. I'm probably pretty rusty.
Not to worry. I'll be here to help you remember. After all, this is your first actual survival mission. I'll be supporting you over the radio.
Where are you, boss? Next to the major?
The boss is communicating with us by radio from aboard a permit-class submarine in the Arctic Ocean.
My frequency is 141.80. Call me if you need my advice on battle techniques.
Gotcha.
Your mission is to retrieve Dr. Sokolov. Dr. Sokolov is being held in an abandoned factory located to the north of your current position. Avoid heavy combat and don't let anyone see you. Don't forget that this is a stealth mission.
Snake, try to remember some of the basics of CQC.
Commencing virtuous mission now.
I see you caught yourself a reticulated python. The reticulated python is said to be the longest snake in the world. The biggest ones can grow up to 10 meters in length. Although they're not poisonous, they're still very dangerous, so be careful around them. They have a highly ferocious temperament, and they can swallow whole, even large animals like deer and pigs. Their most distinguishing feature is the mesh pattern of their scales. This pattern acts as a highly effective natural camouflage. If you think there might be a reticulated python about, pay close attention to your surroundings. Otherwise, you could get bitten before you even know it's there. It's a huge snake, but you should be able to capture it alive by using the tranquilizer gun. I'll bet if you capture one and throw it at an enemy, it'll give him a good scare.
Right. But how do they taste?
Huh?
Do they taste good?
You're actually going to eat one.
Why else would I be asking?
Cannibal.
What was that?
Nothing. Let's see what the guide says. Ah, you're in luck. It says they taste pretty good.
Good. I can hardly wait.
Ugh. I see you've captured a giant anaconda. The giant anaconda is believed to be the largest snake in the world. I see you found some Siberian inkcap mushrooms. The Siberian inkcap is a mushroom from the inkcap family. Its life cycle is transitory. As soon as the spores mature, the cap starts to turn black, liquefy, and melt away.
And that's why they call it an ink cap?
That's right. It doesn't really turn to liquid, but you get the idea. In its immature state, before it melts away, it's valued as a source of food. Just be sure not to eat them while you're drinking alcohol.
Why's that?
Ink caps contain coprin, which inhibits the function of aldehyde dehydrogenase. This prevents the body from breaking down alcohol, causing a buildup of acetaldehyde.
Meaning?
Meaning it will give you the hangover from hell.
Oh. Wait a minute.
What?
You think I'd drink alcohol in the middle of a mission?
Wouldn't you?
Hell no.
Well, I'm knocking a shot back now.
What?
Just teasing you. Oh, come on. Where's your sense of humor?
I need a drink.
The gauge below your life gauge is your stamina gauge. It shows, as the name suggests, your remaining stamina. As you consume stamina, your natural life regeneration is slowed and your hands shake more. Your O2 gauge and grip gauge also become shorter. Excessively low stamina can often impede your mission objectives. Make sure you replenish stamina before that occurs. That area is inhabited by Indian gavials. The Indian gavial is a crocodile that originally lived in freshwater regions in India and Nepal.
Why are Indian crocodiles way out here?
They're captive crocodiles that were brought here for research purposes but escaped and became wild again. Indian gavials are large creatures. Adult males grow to over 6 meters in length. You'll never catch one alive, even if you use the tranquilizer gun.
Got it. So, how do they...
taste? Yes, I did look into that. You know what they always say. Tastes like chicken.
Sounds delicious.
But be careful when capturing an Indian gavial. Normally they're cowardly creatures. But the ones in the forest there are belligerent. Apparently they attack humans.
What do you mean?
They weren't the direct subject of any serious research, but some think they may have become violent as a side effect of the atomic research that was conducted nearby. Thank you.
procedure. I've spotted two enemy soldiers.
They're probably KGB troops sent to guard Sokolov.
AK-47s and grenades.
Snake, your presence in Soviet territory is already a violation of international law. We can't let the Kremlin find out that the CIA and the American government are involved. Contact with the enemy is strictly prohibited. Don't engage them in battle either. This is a stealth mission. Got that?
The Major is right. The point of this mission is to sneak through the jungle without being seen. The success of the mission depends on how well you use your camouflage. Change your camouflage by selecting Camouflage from the Survival Viewer. The Uniform option lets you pick your uniform, while the Face option lets you change your face paint. Choosing camouflage that blends in with your surroundings will help you conceal yourself more effectively. Also, don't forget that anything that moves will stand out in the jungle. If you just stand up and run around like an idiot, you're bound to be spotted. But if you crawl instead, you should be able to sneak by without being noticed. You can see how effective your camouflage is by looking at the camo index. The camo index shows how well your current camouflage blends in with the surrounding area. The higher the value, the harder you are to spot, and vice versa. The key is to make yourself one with nature. Keep that in mind as you go along, okay?
Just my imagination. Just my imagination. Thank you. just my imagination.
Huh?
I see you've got yourself a Baltic hornet's nest. Baltic hornets are a variety of hornets that inhabit that area. The difference between them and other hornets is that they produce honey in their nests. Inside the nests are larvae, pupa, and adults. You can eat them all. In particular, the honey you find inside the nest is delicious and full of nutrients. It's easy to digest and helps pep you up when you're feeling tired. In short, it's the perfect survival food. Honey can also be used as a burn ointment. When honey is applied to a burn, it creates a protective coating over the skin. When you knock down a hornet's nest, a burn ointment will appear along with it, so don't forget to pick it up. Of course, the hornets aren't going to give up their nest without a fight. If you knock a nest down, a large swarm of hornets will come flying out, so be careful. I see you have a calorie mate.
Calorie mate?
The thing you're holding now?
Oh, the little block that looks like a cookie?
Try it, it's pretty good.
Okay, but what is this thing? Never seen anything like it.
Calorie Mate is an energy supplement that contains all the proteins, lipids, vitamins, carbohydrates, and minerals needed for a balanced diet. It's a well-balanced food. Because of that, it's just perfect for giving your body the nutrition it needs in combat.
It sounds like a space-age food.
Real astronaut food is not very good, but that should taste fine.
Yeah, and it'll help balance out all this jungle food I'm eating.
It's easy and quick to eat, so it's perfect when you're running late for an important mission in the morning.
I've never been late for a mission.
Really? Aren't you always keeping people waiting?
Huh?
It's easy to keep track of your calorie intake and receive the nutrition your body needs, so it's good for losing weight, too. All of the geisha girls in Japan use it for watching their calories.
Is that why they're all so slim?
Right. And any diet where you eat nothing at all is bad for the body.
I see. You seem to know a lot about Japan, don't you?
Yes. I love Japan. I see you found a Yabloko Maloko.
Yablo what now?
Yabloko Maloko. It's a Russian name that roughly translates as milk apple. It's a type of star apple. The juice is thick and sweet, like milk, hence the name. And if you cut one in half lengthwise, you'll see a star-shaped ring radiating out from the center.
Hence the star apple.
Right. The star-shaped part has a gelatinous texture and is said to be especially tasty.
Sounds useful.
You're welcome.
For once.
Did you say some...
No, back to the mission.
Just my imagination.
Thank you. The enemy's here.
Major, I've reached the abandoned factory where Sokolov is supposedly being held. This place is a dump. I can't see Sokolov from here. The security is pretty tight. There are sentries posted around the perimeter. I wonder how many are inside.
Your objective, Sokolov, is inside the factory. They should be holding him in a room in the northeast section.
Northeast section. Got it.
Be careful. Your mission is to bring Sokolov back alive. He must not be exposed to any kind of danger. Do not approach Sokolov while in the alert phase.
Right.
Oh, and one more thing, Snake.
You mean there's more?
No, it's just that when you get to Sokolov, I want you to tell him something from me.
And that is?
Sorry for being so late.
Is that all?
Yes.
Understood. Beginning my approach to the target.
Thank you. HQ.
Patrol here. We've lost sight of the enemy. Defense alert formation.
Acknowledged. The enemy is still nearby. Pursue and engage him.
Nobody here.
What's that sound?
There's nothing.
Huh? I hear something.
Did you hear something? HQ.
This is HQ.
Patrol here. Unable to locate the problem.
Understood. Return to your position.
Thank you. seeing things. Huh? I heard footsteps.
Nobody here.
Who's that?
Control here. We've lost sight of the enemy. Commence alert formation.
Acknowledged. The enemy is still nearby. Pursue and engage him.
What's wrong?
Some.
Saving the game, Snake? Hey, Snake, you ever heard of Godzilla, King of Monsters?
No, what is it?
It's a movie. You haven't seen it?
Nope.
It's about this monster called Godzilla, who grows to an enormous size in a nuclear test and goes on a rampage in Tokyo.
Nuclear test, huh? Then the Marshall Islands must be crawling with giant monsters right about now.
It's just make-believe.
Maybe that's why my pants have been so tight lately.
Snake, it's a movie, not a report out of Los Alamos.
I know. So then what happened?
Godzilla is immune to all weapons, and humanity has no way to stop the monster. Dr. Serizawa develops a new type of weapon, but meanwhile, Godzilla is getting closer and closer to Tokyo, obliterating everything in its path. It was originally a Japanese movie, but they made an American version, too. I recommend seeing the Japanese one if you ever get the chance. It's mostly mindless fun, but it's also got a serious anti-nuke message as well.
Where can I see the original?
You'll just have to go to Japan.
Really? That's too bad.
Well, if you wait 40 years, you might be able to see it in America, too.
Why is that?
2004 will be Godzilla's 50th birthday.
You think they're still going to be making Godzilla movies then?
Of course. Everybody loves Godzilla.
You sure know a lot about movies.
I don't suppose you're the movie-watching type, are you?
Not really.
Okay, then I'll tell you everything I know. When the going gets tough, movies can save your life. It's always good to be able to look at things from a different perspective when you get in a jam. That's the magic of movies.
No kidding. Well, I guess it might at least make a nice distraction.
That's the spirit, Snake. Have a little fun.
Patrol here. Unable to locate the problem.
Understood. Return to your position.
I see you've caught yourself a Sunda whistling thrush. The Sunda whistling thrush is a bird native to Java and Sumatra. It's distinguished by its large blue body and long beak. It really stands out in the forest.
Got it. So...
how does it taste?
Yeah.
I don't know.
You don't know?
The guide doesn't say. I guess there's no reason we couldn't eat them.
Oh, I see.
But it's nice and plump, so I'm sure it'd make a hearty meal.
That's a good point. You must be Sokolov.
Are you one of Vulcan's men? You'll never get it from me.
No. I'm a CIA agent. I've come to escort you back to the other side of the Iron Curtain.
You're CIA?
Yeah. I was sent by Major Zero, the man who got you out 2 years ago.
Zero?
I have a message from him.
What is it?
He said to tell you sorry for being so late.
Did he now?
What does it mean?
It means he's a man of his word. But we've got no time for this. You have to get me out of here before they arrive.
Who's they?
Colonel Vulcan of Gru. You in the West know him as Thunderbolt.
Thunderbolt? Never heard of him.
He's a member of the Army's extremist faction, a man who seeks to seize control of the motherland. Ever since the Cuban Missile Crisis 2 years ago, Khrushchev has been pursuing a policy of peaceful coexistence with the West. Despite resistance and criticism from hawks in the Army and the provincial authorities, Khrushchev has managed to suppress the opposition so far. But the failure of his agricultural policies has put him in a precarious position. And on top of that, the tragedy last November.
President Kennedy's assassination.
Precisely. In a sense, Khrushchev has lost his biggest partner, and his power base is rapidly crumbling away. A certain group is plotting to use this opportunity to seize power by rallying the anti-government forces, overthrowing Khrushchev, and installing Brezhnev and Kosygin in his place. The mastermind behind this plot is Colonel Vulcan of the Gru. He has control over another secret weapons research facility much like this one, OKB-812, known as the Gronin Design Bureau, and is using it to further his plans. But that is not enough to satisfy him. Now he's plotting to seize the secret weapon I have been developing here and use it as leverage in his bid for power. The intelligence says that they are going to make their move during the test.
Then, the soldiers outside.
Exactly. They wouldn't need that many men just to keep me inside. Their orders were to prevent Colonel Vulcan from capturing me. Even if it meant killing me in the process. So it would seem. Vulcan will come. I'm sure of it. You must get me out of here before then.
Leave it to me.
By the way, your Russian is superb. Where did you learn to speak it?
From my mentor.
Is that so? America is truly a frightening country.
Having second thoughts?
No. I have no love for this place. Let's go.
Major, this is Snake. Sokolov is safe with me. He's doing fine. No injuries.
Good work, Snake. Now hurry up and get Sokolov to the recovery point. We'll rendezvous with you there.
Roger.
What about the sentries?
I managed to get past them.
I see.
What about the boss?
We lost contact with the boss some time ago.
What happened?
It's probably just a weak signal. Just hurry and get Sokolov out of there.
Thank you. Freeze!
So this is the legendary boss.
Huh?
You're from the Ocelot unit of Spetsnaz.
Huh.
What's a Gru soldier doing here?
Soldier?
He's the Ocelot commander.
That's Major Ocelot to you. Don't you forget it.
Sokolov is ours. Now get out of here.
An Ocelot never lets his prey escape.
What?
I can't say it feels good to kill a comrade, even if it is for the Gru.
Sokolov, take cover.
Huh. You're not the boss, are you? What is that stance? Huh. That gun. If you're not the boss, then die.
The other one.
Ah!
You ejected the first bullet by hand, didn't you? I see what you were trying to do, but testing a technique you've only heard about in the middle of battle wasn't very smart. You were asking to have your gun jam on you. Besides, I don't think you're cut out for an automatic in the first place. You tend to twist your elbow to absorb the recoil. That's more of a revolver technique.
You filthy American dog!
But that was some fancy shooting. You're pretty good.
Pretty good.
Major, do you read me?
I read you. Snake, you all right?
I've run into a few snags. These guys were after Sokolov, too. Apparently, they were taking orders from a GRU colonel named Volgin.
A GRU colonel?
Part of an internal Soviet power struggle, according to Sokolov. Something between the KGB and GRU. Between Khrushchev's supporters and Volgin's.
Sokolov was being guarded by the KGB and hunted by GRU? Snake, it sounds like this could be even hotter than Cuba.
I don't like it. Something about the whole thing stinks.
I agree. You'd better hurry.
Sokolov ran off by himself, but I'll catch up to him.
We're counting on you.
I see you caught yourself a rat. The rats in that area are the descendants of wild Norway rats that were domesticated by humans as pets and lab animals. They're not poisonous, and I don't think they'll attack you, but they're quick little creatures, so you might have a hard time catching one. By the way, Snake.
What?
What was that little lecture back there?
Lecture?
You were instructing the GRU commander, weren't you? Something about the first round or his hand?
Yeah.
What was that supposed to mean?
Whenever he put a new clip in his gun, he'd always load the first round by hand, whether there was a round left in the chamber or not. It's a technique they teach in the Middle East. By making sure there's always a round in the chamber, you eliminate the risk of pulling the trigger with nothing to fire. He must have heard about it from someone or read it somewhere. In any case, he probably wanted to try it out for himself. And he was obviously motivated by vanity to show off his new technique. That's when you make mistakes. The battlefield is an unforgiving place. The only techniques you can rely on are the ones you've mastered through experience and practice.
Uh-huh. And what were you saying about him being more suited to revolvers?
When he fired, he was bending his elbow sharply to avoid the recoil. It looked like he wasn't aware he was doing it, but that habit can be either a fatal flaw or a gift.
What do you mean?
Automatic weapons use recoil to operate, so if you don't let the recoil hit you, it interferes with the operating cycle of the gun. Basically, he shouldn't be trying to avoid the impact like that. But with a revolver, there's no need to let the recoil hit you. Just the opposite. Avoiding the recoil lets you reduce the strain on your hand and arm. That kid might just be handy with a high-caliber revolver.
Handy? Are you listening to yourself?
What do you mean?
He's the enemy. Why are you giving him advice?
I...
Snake.
I don't know. For some reason, I couldn't help but point it out to him.
Snake, are you all right?
Yeah.
Okay. Those men were from the Ocelot unit.
Spetsnaz?
Yes. The best crew has to offer. They're coming for me. I'm finished!
Calm down. I'll get you out of here, I promise. And we've got some of the best backup we could ask for.
Look. Yes. The Shagahod. The treading behemoth. A tank capable of launching nuclear IRBMs.
It can launch nuclear missiles from that kind of terrain?
Oh, yes. And without support from friendly units.
A nuclear-equipped tank capable of operating solo. Is that thing finished?
No. This is only the end of Phase 1. It won't be truly finished until we complete Phase 2.
Phase 2?
The weapon's true form. If it is completed and the Colonel gets his hands on it, it will mean the end of the Cold War.
The end of the Cold War?
Yes. And then the Age of Fear will truly begin.
A world war.
I had no choice but to cooperate. Didn't want to die. I wanted to see my wife and child again in America. Please, take me to America, quickly. They cannot complete it without my help.
Got it. Let's go.
Ooh.
boss.
Good work, Jack.
What are you doing here?
Sokolov comes with me. My friends, let us fight together again.
I have waited long for this day.
We will fight with you once more.
Welcome back, boss.
Now that all five of us are together, it's time we go to the depths of hell itself. It's raining blood. Is he crying?
Kuwabara, Kuwabara.
Ah, what a joyful scene.
Colonel Vogan.
Welcome to my country. And to my unit.
Boss, what is this?
I'm defecting to the Soviet Union. Sokolov is a little gift from my new hosts.
Recoilless nuclear warheads. These will make a fine gift for me.
This can't be happening.
Who is he? Another one of your disciples? Are we taking him with us?
No, this one is still just a child. Too pure for us Cobras. He has not yet found an emotion to carry into battle.
What are you talking about?
Think you can pull the trigger?
My face. We can't let him live. If Khrushchev finds out about this, we're finished. He must die.
Wait. He's my apprentice. I'll take care of him. Jack, you can't come with us.
Comrade has been rejected. Are we done here?
Now, onto Sokolov's research facility.
Shagohod is ours.
Drift away. My place is with them now.
Snake, can you hear me?
Yeah, just barely.
Snake, listen to me. You need emergency medical treatment. Can you move? You've got to get those wounds treated. Hang in there. All right, let's get you fixed up. Paramedic?
Okay, Snake. Just relax and it'll all be over before you know it. Stay with me. I've seen people in worse shape before. Think you can handle it?
Major. The boss. She's defected.
We'll talk about that later. First, we've got to get you patched up.
Okay, here we go. First, open the survival viewer with the start button. If you select cure, you can start the treatment. Healing is divided into treatment using medicine with the item window button, and surgical treatment using the weapon window button. Your injuries include a fractured left elbow and rib bone, and lacerations on your upper arms, right elbow, and abdomen. They need to be fixed using surgical treatment. Move the healing cursor with the left analog stick to the affected part of your body. Once you've selected the affected area, hold the weapon window button and use the left analog stick to select the medical item, and then press the enter button. With this method, you can use items to help your recovery process. To treat a bone fracture, first secure the affected area with a fastener and then wrap it in bandages. That should do it. For lacerations, you'll need disinfectant to clean the wound, sutures to stitch it up, styptic to slow the flow of blood, and bandages to wrap the wound. If you do everything I mentioned, the wound should heal completely. Understood?
Yeah.
Stay with me. Go into the survival viewer and treat those wounds.